is on innovation and the evolution of more centers of excellence in Abuja to give it an additional edge as an elite university and sustain it as such. Today, Abuja is ranked among the best in law, in medicine, in accounting, entrepreneurship, and sustainable development in Nigeria. We want Abuja to take on a fifth discipline as a center of national and global excellence. I suggest we turn in the direction of being a center of excellence in artificial intelligence and cybersecurity. These are new, ladies and gentlemen, these are new directions in the global world of scholarship, innovation, and practice. Senate of Abuja, under the leadership of our Vice Chancellor, Professor Ajijafe, should work out a strategic plan for actualizing this goal that by 2025, this university, Afe Babalola University, Ado Ekiti, is Nigeria's number one in artificial intelligence and cybersecurity. As I close, Chancellor, dear students, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, we have spent the last 20 minutes or so discussing how Abuja can continue its winning streak as a global brand in quality. I talked about 107 variables being elements in the quality equation. Time permitted deeper discussion of a few of the variables we have considered to be of exceptional potency in promoting and sustaining quality. If Abuja seeks first, you know, well, this say in the Bible, seek it first, can you complete it? The kingdom of God, all other things will be added unto you. If Abuja, Chancellor, sir, and Father, seeks first the seven cardinal principles I enumerated, all other quality dividends will be added unto us. Thank you, Daddy, our most revered Chancellor and Founder, for giving me the opportunity to speak at this matriculation event. It's a collective prayer, that God grants you more decades in good health to continue to see Abuja soar, soar, and soar. In your lifetime, Abuja will leap to the number one position in law, medicine, artificial intelligence, cybersecurity in Africa, north and south of the Sahara, and continue to be a global brand. I thank you all for your attention.
Please, are we set up to celebrate Professor Okebo Bola? Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, before I invited Professor Okebo Bola to the podium a short while ago, I did say he's eminently so qualified to address us on the issue of quality assurance in the university system. I say without any doubt in my mind that has been more than confirmed in whom we. He told us the seven cardinal principles we have to follow to stay on course. At least I grabbed those ones. We must admit quality students, employ good quality teachers, engage in pre-accreditation review. We must reward good behavior for staff, for students, and above all, that nobody is or should be above the law. We should ensure quality teaching and learning and research. We went ahead to say that the reward system is one of the best in the world, and we should entrench a center of excellence here. Sir, we appreciate you. But I want to mention this. Prophetically, you have said before the year runs out, after Bala, we have a new accolade. We are waiting, sir. And finally, sir, you describe yourself as a poor teacher, poor lecturer, and yet you are donating 1 million. When I grow up, I want to be as poor as you are. Thank you, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. On this note, with your permission, may I invite to this side of the hall Deputy Vice Chancellor, Administration Professor Smaranda Olaride, to please let us in on the milestone achievements. Prof. Ma.
Chancellor of this great citadel of learning, please do permit me to adopt the existing protocol. Thank you. At the 10th matriculation ceremony, AWA 2018 Milestone Academic Achievement. The year 2018 was particularly thrilling in the history of AWA. Among several academic attainments since the establishment of the university, those of 2018 are particularly worthy of note. College of Engineering. The College of Engineering was described by the Nigeria Society of Engineering as the template for engineering education in the country. The College of Sciences, within the same time frame, that is year 2018, UNESCO instituted a professorial chair on entrepreneurship and sustainable development in the College of Sciences. College of Medicine and Health Sciences. In the university's first MBBS examination in July 2018, its students made their mark of academic excellence when the 43 of them presented for the examination recorded an unprecedented 100% pass rate with 8 distinctions, the equivalent of first class in our other disciplines. The accomplishment makes AWA the first university in the country to produce medical doctors in 6.5 years. After its medical program flagged off, why some other universities which commenced their medical program some 2 decades ago are yet to graduate their first set of medical doctors. The best overall graduate students, do permit me to just briefly introduce them. Best 2018 AWA graduates with outstanding MBBS performance. Best overall graduating student was Azom Esther Adaobi. The best graduating student leader in the College of Medicine was Adelugba Ayomide Oluwaseun. The best behaved graduating student was Sanya Israel. Why the outstanding student philanthropist Udom Glory Inin. Permit me now to move on to the College of Law 2018 milestone. AWA law graduates stood tall in the externally moderated professional examination, the 2018 final bar examination of the Nigerian Law School. The College of Law graduates recorded the following outstanding performance. 100% pass rate. 2, the overall best student, ECOP, Naomi Uwem, emerged first among 6,000 students who took the examination. ECOP Naomi Uwem is also the recipient of 13 prizes. And AWA graduates are the recipient of 24 awards out of the total of 36 awarded by the Council of Legal Education. The College of Law, in partnership with the Nigerian Institute of Chartered Arbitrators, conducted training programs for law students while at the undergraduate level. The institute also examined them and conferred the successful students with an associate membership of the institute. At graduation, the students of the College of Law had already been inducted associate members of the prestigious Nigerian Institute of Chartered Arbitrators. Please, the next table shows the details of awards of Harvard first class graduates at the 2018 final bar examination of the Nigerian Law School. Number one, Adepoju Blessing, prize for first class students given by Director General Nigerian Law School. Two, Adewale Mary Tofarati, the same prize given by the Director General Nigerian Law School, prize for first class students. Adunmo Oluwatosin Mary Jane, prize for first class students, donor is the Director General Nigerian Law School. Four, Akinyemi Ayomide, prize for first class students, Director General Nigerian Law School. Fifth, Danagogo Biobele, she also received the prize for first class students given by the Director General Nigerian Law School. Morume Sandra Ozioma also received first class students awarded by the Director General Nigerian Law School. Seven, Ojigoro Ogeneyoma received the prize for first class students of the Director General Nigerian Law School. Eight, Opajobi Ayomide Bukola also received prize for first class students given by the Director General Law School. Nine, Oviodoukiti Fidelis, prize for first class students given by the Director General Nigerian Law School. Ten, Tayo Zeina Mustafa, prize for first class students, Director General Nigerian Law School. Yinusa Ajarat, prize for first class students given by the Director General of the Nigerian Law School. Please let us now see the 12 students, Ekop Naomi Uwem. Please may grave the indulgence of the audience to call Ekop Naomi Uwem, who is here with us in the hall, and the other three students. We cannot see you, please. You may wish to come for the audience to see you better. Come, please, on the red carpet. Miss Ekop Naomi Uwem. She received 2018 Best Overall Graduating Student. The donor is Council of Legal Education. Two, she received the prize of Council of Legal Education Star Prize. Three, prize in civil litigation by Justice Olujide Somolu, first prize. Four, best overall female student of the year. Donor is the National Association of Women Judges. Five, best female student in civil litigation. Prize received from Honorable Justice Aloma Maria Mukhtar, GCON. Six, best female student in civil and criminal litigation. Prize given by Chief Ike Gadzoma, OFR, MFR, Senior Advocate of Nigeria. Seven, best overall female student. Donor Nigerian Bar Association. 8, Best Student of the Year, Donor Sir Adetokunbo Ademolam, KBE GCON. 9, Best Student of the Year, Donor Director General of the Nigerian Law School. And 13, Stephenson Harwood LLP UK Law Firm, 6 months internship, award in London, United Kingdom. May I, with permission of the founder, call the other 3 ladies out of 12 first class recipients to join for the hall to see them as well. Adewale Mary Oluwatofarati, Opajobi Oyinloye Bukolam, and Miss Adepoju Blessing Oluwapa Pamilerin, who received the first class from us at the College of Law, Afe Babalola University, and the law school as well. There are, however, 12. 4 of them are here present at this great ceremony, and I received calls from them that they could not attend this ceremony due to the transportation locations being very far away from Afe Babalola University, Ado-Ekiti. These outstanding performances impressed the much older universities, that congratulatory messages were received from them, including the one from Professor Idowu Olayinka, the 12th Vice Chancellor of the Premier University, the University of Ibadan, which is over 70 years of existence, who stated, and I quote, "Abuad, a private university established less than 10 years, is clearly a star, with the outstanding performance of having a dozen first class. This is what you get where there is strategic investment in human and material resources, for which we warmly congratulate the founder and proprietor, Are Afe Babalola S.A.N. End of the quotation. Yes, I will also want to call at this moment on the student in accounting in the SMS in the Department of Accounting, which her name was mentioned earlier on, Miss Nelieke Ochinike, who emerged second best out of the 2,500 candidates who sat for the examination in West Africa. She emerged second in the whole West Africa. My founder and chancellor, among so many stars, it is not difficult to feel just a star. On this note, I thank you very much, and God bless you all.
I thought you would celebrate these megastars. Please be upstanding. Please, let's celebrate them. Abuad Band, please. So very much, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. Before I invite to the podium Naomi Ekop Esquire to say a word or two on behalf of her colleague, Academic Giants, I want to ask the founder and the vice chancellor a question, sir. I want to ask whether I have your permission to go back to school and study law. Perhaps one of these days I'll be called to come and... Thank you very much. My friend, my colleague, Naomi Ekpo, please be upstanding. Come and say a word or two on behalf of your colleagues. Let's celebrate her, please.
Here for the combination of celebration of the heroes in our midst, and also matriculating the students who are coming in. My simple statement today is that you have come, have seen, you have witnessed. Let us all key into the theme, into the vision and the mission of ABWAD, and all will be well, not only for the education sector, not only for Nigeria, but for humanity, for whom ABWAD exists to advance the cause of knowledge. I thank you.
Thank you very much, Professor Tunde Anedi.
I go to his house. He had one booklet and was unfolding. I said, "What is happening?" He said, "I want to build a university of the status of Australian National University." I just looked at him and said, "Ah, where do you, what?" I thought something was happening. So I just laughed it off. He didn't communicate to me again. 6 months after, he invited me to visit this campus. And I saw structures on ground. I said, "Who permitted you to build these structures?" But when I looked around, they all conformed with the standard of NUC. What we see today is an unfolding vision of a visionary. We all know the origin of universities from medieval Europe, purely Catholic. Two instruments were required to establish universities: the imperial order and the papal bull. So the king was as important as the pope. If you know the history of Frederick Barbarossa, who was crowned king by Pope Adrian, he issued a proclamation, and the pope issued the papal bull. From those two instruments, the universities have evolved. What we see today is what evolved in the 14th and 15th century. Universities were centers of excellence, isolated communities for research development, and they helped government too. We, at some level, also inherited some of those isolated communities. In those days in the Ibadan, there was a signpost: "This is a private property, no trespass." But there were no surprise about that, because universities were first designed for the clergy, to train the clergy. At much later date, they had to introduce others who are not part of the clergy. The academic gown you wear today were first worn by the clergy. And the papal bull and those instruments gave credence to the issue of academic freedom. And what else have you in the university system? But I must say Nigeria has a poor imitation of what they call academic freedom. So what we see today is an old age tradition. If you move to the New World, that's North America, the first universities were by Presbyterian churches and other faith-based institutions. Professor Kwebi Kola has talked about Harvard, Yale, and what is have you. But how I used to know that Yale started with 4 students and a professor and a little library. And Yale was started by the breakaway fashion of the lecturers who were in Harvard, who thought that they were watering down the concept of development of the clergy. That was why Yale did not admit the first female student until as late as 1967, when King Brewster was the president of Yale. And what we see today, we're looking at the students decorated in academic gown. Matriculation is an academic ritual, like baptism in the Catholic Church or other Christian churches. Except you are baptized, you cannot be cleansed from your sin and become a member of the church. But when you have taken the oath of matriculation, you now become a member of the university community. Because university is a community of teachers and scholars. So that's how it has evolved. So what you wear today also started from the clergy. And the clergy were protected. They could do anything and they would not take them to the ordinary court. they will have to be dealt with by the council in the university system. That was why it was difficult to separate the town gown from the university setting. Little observation. We were looking at those who have distinguished themselves in this system, and I asked Professor Okwebukola, where are the boys? I didn't see the boys. I didn't know that Afe Babalola now runs a girls' university. So I will report to the NUC that there is a discrimination in respect of admission of more females. Otherwise, how will you have all the prizes won by the girls? But there's an explanation to that. There's an explanation to that. Are the boys here? Are you here? There's a challenge. It is called the gender quake. Gender quake is an article written by Time magazine. Because the method of teaching in primary and secondary schools now, you find that there are more female teachers. The boys are restless, and nobody really cares about them. No, it's true. So we plead with you that you should work hard. So we celebrate two events today as one. One is the matriculation ceremony, and the other one, we are counting our blessings. When you count your blessings one by one, you will see how much God has done for you. It has been enumerated what we have achieved. Professor Kobukala has told us how to stay in line. I'm not going to repeat most of those things. Like mine, I had something written, and I told her, I said, if I look at the discussion, I will just keep my paper. I don't want to repeat what others have said. But more importantly, we need to examine the success story. Why are we where we are, and where do we go from here? Ordinarily, if you look at the tenure system in the university system, in America, the tenure of a president can last as long as 60 years. But here in Nigeria, for public institution, it's a 5-year tenure. And I ask, if you are an owner of a company and your MD was doing well, will you change him? So I appeal with you. If you have a winning team, keep that team, irrespective of what federal government says about the tenure of professors as vice chancellors. And that goes for all principal officers. There are instances like Kingman Brewster was 14 years as president. There's a female president in the U.S. who has stayed 25 years. So why change a winning team? Because the private universities are like private enterprises. And for you, you are not in the not-for-profit concept. And you must also look at the trending things. We're not talking about Millennium Development Goals and Sustainable Development Goals. Universities must key into the needs of the country itself, regional and national planning system. We have trending issues like climate change, cyber security, and what is have you. And we must be developing the academics of the future. If you don't start developing your academics of the next 2 decades, our students are intelligent enough that you cannot teach them. You see the little child who is 6 years old, he holds an iPad, he says, "Grandpa, this is a hexagon." Some people in my class in secondary school didn't know what a hexagon was. There's so much information in the world that we must develop a new class of academics that will face the challenges of teaching our very, very informed children. Number two, what type of university do you want to become? Is it an entrepreneurial university? I was in Hohenheim University in Germany, a university of agriculture, 1,500 students, but they had a brewery. They had a brewery that was sustaining institution. Do you want to be a research and development institution? Do you want to be an internationalized institution? And also was that, when I looked at the list of students, they are from all parts of the country. But what IBOAD must do, give a few scholarships to African students and from children from other countries. They will enrich your system. That's internationalization. That's what they do with Fulbright, the Rhodes Scholarship, and what is have you. They will be your ambassadors when they leave here. So I congratulate our parents and the students who are boarding first class graduates. I know you all want to make first class possible in IBOAD. And also to tell Afe Babalola that my family and I, and the many thousands of students who cannot have placement in the right system, will bring you very warm felicitations and wish you every success in life. Thank you and God bless you.
Thank you so very much, Prof. We'll take more two of such goodwill messages. I will ensure that it doesn't run outside of 2 minutes. Please, ladies and gentlemen, with two more goodwill messages, very, very short and crisp, I want to call on His Lordship, Honorable Justice Abad Begore, to give us the judicial interpretation of what we are saying. Honorable Begore, please. I bring the microphone to you, sir. Lordship said that God denied him of his rights. Honorable Justice Ahmad Begore, the presiding justice at Adu Ekiti Branch Division of the Court of Appeal. When you talk about judges and lawyers, you have to be careful. You could be charged for puffery, your Lordship.
Grand as of today. I don't
I don't intend to say much. From what we already have on the ground, sky is the limit. See the type of students that are being churned out. They are graduates of world class. I can't say more than to congratulate Arafi Babalola for this feat and to wish Abuad more years of success. Thank you very much.
Thanks so very much, my lord. Crisp to the point. I remember in those days when I used to cover some cases in his court, he used to garnish his judgment with copious Latin phrases. I thought he was going to treat us to sort today. Thank you so very much, sir. On a final note, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I want to invite to this side of the hall the Chief Judge of Ekiti State, Honorable Justice Daramola, for 1 minute. Thank you, my lord.
Today, my heart goes to those of you who have equally received quality education, who may not be getting awards. Don't be discouraged. Many people will not get award, but if you have received sound and quality education, when you get out there, you will excel. So, don't be discouraged. When I was in school, I can't recall receiving awards, but here I am before you today. So, to those of you, I'm imploring you to work hard. Not even all the first class students got award at the law school, apart from their director general. It's a general award, but the fact remains that they have all received quality education. So, whether you get award or not, the raising the tower of good academy or good education is for you to get sound knowledge. If you get sound knowledge, you will excel out there. And to Abuad, I wish you many more years of academic excellence here. And the founder, somebody said before me, more decades of living in this side of life. I think Chief is almost 90 or even above now. When you say more decades, we are talking about maybe 120, 130 years now or more. I salute you. Those of you who are just coming, you have seen what your predecessors have done. I'm very sure after 6 years, which I believe that's the length of medicine here, 6 years, engineering, law, 5 years, many of you will be coming here again to be celebrated. And those of you who will not be celebrated, quote and unquote, I wish you all well. Thank you, and God bless you.
Thank you so very much, my Lord. When he was called upon, he said, I'm not an orator. I don't make it. I deliver judgments. Thanks for your judgment, sir. It is appreciated. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, we want to wind down this segment of the celebration. How do we run it? We do that by inviting our founder, Areyape Babalola. Oh, I'm sorry. Before him, our regulator is in the house. Executive Secretary of the NUC, ably represented by our friend and brother, Dr. Chris Mayaki. Goodwill message, sir. Thank you. A prospective alumnus of our board.
Thank you. Thank you very much, MC. Let me start with the RA for strategic reasons. The RA himself, the founder, chancellor of Afe Babalola University. I should say a man of quite extraordinary energy, an advocate for those who others may have forgotten. Let me also note, say that there have been many days in the life of this giant of an IRA that are more than a coincidence. Having been tested like any other mortal on a number of occasions, and today it is heartwarming, like on any other day of his life, that he can look back with gratitude and sing praises to his Creator. The chairman and members of the Board of Trustees, the chairman and members of the Governing Council, the Vice Chancellor and his formidable team, staff, and proud parents, members of the Fourth Estate of the Realm, the Chief George of Ekiti State, if I got that right, distinguished participants, ladies and gentlemen. Sorry, I have to be very selfish here because the protocol list will not be complete and history will not forgive me if I do not mention two important personalities, two important benefactors of mine who have served this country and who continue to do so with distinction, who have nurtured, supported, and always treated me as a son and with exceptionally warm embrace. Only God Almighty can reward Professors Peter Akinshola Okebukola and Professor Julius Amioba Okoje, who out of the five executive secretaries that I've privileged to serve in my nearly 27 years of service with the National Universities Commission. Now, to the business of the day. They call the ears of the NUC, but I'm not the ears of the NUC. The executive secretary, Professor Abubakar Adamu Rashid, MNIMFR, a trusted friend of this university, a partner in progress, is unavoidably absent. In the circumstance, he has asked me, he literally conscripted me last night to proceed to Ado Ekiti because of the importance that he attaches to this ceremony. He said, "Chris, I don't know how you're going to get to Ekiti, but just find your way." And so this is why you would excuse my late arrival. He also made sure that he personally signed a letter to the RMs. So the ESNUC, Professor Abubakar Adamu Rashid, is actually speaking now, not Chris Mayahi. The letter, it says, "My dear RM, it is with great pride and a deep sense of fulfillment on behalf of the National Universities Commission, together with the entire Nigerian university system, that I bring you this message of goodwill to most profoundly communicate our warm felicitations, fraternal greetings, and best wishes to the founder and his beloved wife, Board of Trustees, the Chairman and members of the Governing Council, the Vice-Chancellor, the management team, the hard-working and ever-dedicated students of Afe Babalola University. On the auspicious occasion of the celebration of the 2018 Monumental Academic Achievements of Abuad, the most recent approval granted by the Commission for an increase in the admission quota for medicine puts this university among the top 5 universities offering medicine in the country. This is a clear testimony to the huge investments in world-class academic and clinical facilities, quality staff, and other learning resources. The Commission, the National Universities Commission, also recognizes the university's outstanding performance, where 43 pioneer doctors attained 100% with 8 distinctions in their 2018 final MBBS exam. In the same vein, the recent increase in the law admission quota took into cognizance the remarkable performance by the university's law graduates, as was further confirmed during the recent 2018 bar examinations conducted by the Council for Legal Education, when the overall best student came from Abuad, while 24 out of the 36 available prizes were won by students of this great university. The accomplishments in accounting, the recent UNESCO chair in entrepreneurship and sustainable development, among several other laurels, is an attestation to the rising profile of a world-class university. The National Universities Commission, being the flagship regulatory and quality assurance agency for university education, acknowledges the audacity and the unshaking conviction with which the founder and chancellor, R.A. Afe Babalola, has peerlessly applied himself to the arduous task of providing qualitative, inclusive, and robust university education in Nigeria. From the many notable achievements recorded so far, it is crystal clear that an institution that is barely 9 years to have achieved this much within a short period, considering our daunting ecosystem, must have been a Herculean task for everyone involved in this laudable project of a qualitative, stable, and modern learning environment. As we are gathered to celebrate the many feats by Afe Babalola University in the preceding year, I'm confident, that's Professor Rashid speaking now, that the target set by the National Universities Commission in its blueprint for the rapid revitalization of university education in Nigeria are not only achievable, but that there is a promising opportunity that they will provide the solutions to some of the national and global challenges confronting mankind, for which we commend your doggedness, and hereby affirm the unequivocal support of the National Citizens Commission. Here I would like to single out the chairman of this NUC steering committee in the person of Professor Okebukola for his continued hard work, dedication. We thank you so much, sir. In conclusion, I avail myself of this opportunity to renew the assurances of our highest regards and best wishes for more successes and a much better year to come and more years to come. Congratulations. Thank you for listening and good afternoon. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much, the representative of the Executive Secretary at UC, our friend and brother, Dr. Meyaki. We have in the house, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, Professor Ben Adewuji, the Director of Quality Assurance, PUTA, representing his boss. You are welcome. Even though my friend and my brother has deliberately elected to take a back seat, I present to you the distinguished ladies and gentlemen, member of the Governing Council of the University, Dr. Buye Gabawalula. You are welcome. We have in the house the CMD, Federal Teaching Hospital, Edo Ekiti, Dr. Kunle Ajayi. You are welcome. And of course, our big brother, Otumba Senator B. Idrojai, a member of the Board of Trustees. You are welcome, sir. To round up this segment, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, as I was saying the other time, I want to invite to this side of the hall a man you are familiar with, a lawyer, an engineer, a nurse, a hairdresser, a farmer. I'm talking about a soldier, a general. Troy has an NDA. A man whose name opens doors of opportunities. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, put your hand together for Are Emmanuel Ebuoluwa Afebabalola as he takes this center stage. Here today.
this purpose, I will call on our people there to release a song which I love so much. Are you ready? Appreciation.
Appreciation. Mo dupe oni bu ore baba gbo pe mi. Appreciation.
Everybody now.
Oni bu ore baba gbo pe mi.
Affair Babalola University,
indeed all staff and students of this university want to show how proud we are of you. You are a great ambassador of this university, and we want to give you this. It is 525,000 naira, which we are presenting to you, and with a request that we should keep doing above. Proud. Congratulations.
Ochinke Onelike and her proud parents and teachers and associates here present, on behalf of this welcoming learning environment, on behalf of the entire Nigerian university system, it is my absolute pleasure to congratulate you for carving a niche for yourself, for accounting for your parents' investments and your own time, and for emerging the overall best. May this be the beginning of more promotion and more successes to come your way. Congratulations and God bless. I have here 200 million, no, 200,000. Yeah. 220,000 naira. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the father of the lucky girl.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
What we have done is to inspire you. Celebrating the extraordinary achievements we have made. One of some people who have said, assistance us is respected Vice Chancellor of the Premier University, Ibadan. You'll be happy to hear what another university said about us. Then you will know where you are. Afebola University, Adekiti, a private university established less than 10 years ago, is clearly a star with the outstanding performance of having a dozen first class. This is what you get when there is strategic investment in human resources, for which we warmly the founder, Ari Afebabaola, and so on and so forth. I've read the opinion of many colonial masters about Africa. I don't know how many of you have had this before. One of them was Lord Lugard, who wrote about Africans, and he said, quote, "The typical African is lacking in self-control, lacking in discipline, lacking foresight. Thoughts are concentrated in the events and feelings of the moment, and has suffered the appreciation or grief for the past. His mind is far nearer to the world than that of the European or Asiatic. His want of desire to rise beyond the state he has reached. He lacks the power of organization, usually deficient in management and control alike of men and business. He loves display of power but fails to realize his responsibility." When I read this, I wrote 5 articles on it. So that he was not right. But events of today in this country show that probably. But when you look at Abuad today, what we have achieved in 8 years, I can proudly and boldly say that we have put Lord Lugard and those who shared his view about Africans, that we can make it. I think we deserve an applause for that. That we have showed that we can make it. It's not right for him, for white people to think blacks cannot do it. What we are doing today, what we have achieved here, or what we have started here, is a revolution. Silent revolution. I can proudly and boldly say that we have put Lugard on. Your cooperation, educational revolution has begun in Abuad. We are building a new generation of Nigerians. Students who are disciplined, students who are highly industrious, trustworthy, and respectful. Above all, students who are kind. These are the people we train here. Who are those walking away there? Will you go back, please? Security. Nobody must move. Ladies and gentlemen, we are building a new generation of Nigerians. My students constitute the new generation. And therefore, we are building a new Nigeria, which we'll be proud of. If you have time, come to visit me. I will show you letters written by my students who have graduated and what they have achieved, where they are, and how they are treated elsewhere. We are happy that as professor and regulator at the AUC, another stakeholder have applauded the revolution which has brought us here. At this stage, I have a request from you. I knew the problem you had in coming to this place. The roads are bad and narrow. We have no airport. When I started this institution here, I was forced to bring it here. I can tell you that it was supposed to be at Ibadan. I knew the importance of the airport. Immediately, I approached the governor who was there then, and we went to Abuja. And the government approved an airport for Adekiti, for Bayelsa, for Asaba and Gombe. We started
devoted 618 million to start with it. And the airport is very close to us here. And finally, the governor who took over from him said airport was not his priority. We have since been trying to get the airport back. If any one of you is sympathetic with me and with what we are doing here, please join us in appealing to those in power to continue to give us the land. I can build it. People, we can get the land. I can build the airport myself. We have excelled in all examinations which are national. Whereas other universities where they do not even sit for more than two weeks in a term, we still come out with first class, second class, and so on and so forth. Thereby rubbishing our degree in Nigeria. I'm appealing to the NUC here, those who are in charge of education, to please make it mandatory that all universities at the end of the final year must take the same examination. Give us a round of applause for that. It is only then that we can improve the quality of education in this country. I'm going to put up a special paper to the government on it. And those of you who are in position, please support the father to ensure that every university does what we are doing here. Studying, no strike, day and night, monitoring the students, mentoring them, to make them what we are. Let us have the same examination at the end of every year, final year. Finally, the task before us now is not to start a new university. We have made it. The task is how to maintain the high standard we have set for ourselves. This was why we requested the highly respected Chairman Professor Kukola to address on how to sustain these milestone achievements. Sir, we are grateful to you, sir. You've given us 7 cardinal principles. I'm going to follow them strictly. And where need be, we will invite you. We must sustain the high standard we have set for ourselves. Your children must go out with first class, second class upper, and compete with anybody, anywhere in the world. I thank you for listening to me. Bless you all. Once more.
Marks the end of this first segment of this
celebration. The next segment, which is of equal importance, is the matriculation ceremony. Of equal importance. But then, immediately after that, we go out of the hall to this other side. Outside there, with people talk about PPP, public-private partnership. But here in Aboad, the place of parents and teachers in what we do here is of paramount import. And that is why the teachers and the parents, in their wisdom, have put up a befitting 2,000-seater auditorium for use of the university. That will be commissioned this morning. And that was why I said we are here for multiple celebration. So in a jiffy, the matriculation ceremony will commence, and I can assure you it will be rounded off inside of 30 minutes. Let me say this, in addition to the fact that this ceremony is being broadcast live,